Are we all here, girls?
Yes, yes.
Okay, open chapter 4. Yes. And the Odyssey. What do you think of the Odyssey, girls?
Entertaining.
Entertaining. What else?
It's full of suspense.
Full of suspense. What else? Okay.
Intriguing. Intriguing. Like, I want to know what happens next. It's my first time with the literature stories.
Yes. Really? With this? Yes. Great. I want to show you some YouTube videos. Oh, I didn't share the sound. I have to reshare it again. To reshare it. Every time I say that, I say re the, and the verb, and then I say again. And there is no need to say again. I just have to say re and the verb, and that's it. Why I don't say, why I say re and the verb and again? Why? Here is it. Okay. You see my PowerPoint?
That's YouTube or PowerPoint or the YouTube?
YouTube.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Actually, there are lots of videos, but I prefer to read. Why? When we read, we imagine, we create the image in our minds. Then we watch. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So here is it, girls.
Unless tomorrow's games accept this sacrifice, we have honored the god. Apollo will be favorable tomorrow. If I win the games, I shall sleep in the bed of Ulysses. And to thank the god for this magnificent victory, I shall cut the throat of every goat in the island.
You were born to be a leader, Eurymachus. And for this, you are prepared to risk everything on one day.
I do not envy the winner.
But you do not think it worth much to become king of Ithaca.
The new king of Ithaca should learn to sleep lightly.
What does that mean?
There will be daggers behind every column, poison in every goblet, a plot in every smile.
Come now, Ulysses is at the bottom of the sea, or maybe on some beach with his bones rotting in the sun, food for the hawks but now.
Do you know who are these girls?
Suitors?
Yes, the suitors of Penelope. Yes.
Penelope, Ulysses doesn't trouble me.
To whom do you refer then?
Telemachus.
Telemachus is only a boy.
Have you seen the look in his eyes?
What do you mean?
As soon as the wedding is over, there should be more than goats sacrificed. Don't you agree? Penelope, forgive this intrusion. I have so much to say to you.
What can we have to say to each other?
I know that you're sad, disturbed, afraid. But I want to tell you that you need have no fear. That I shall bring you happiness.
You.
Do you doubt that I shall win tomorrow?
That will depend on your skill. But if you do win, I shall not complain of having to choose a man like you.
Now at last you speak like a woman who's true.
My son of life. Penelope, there is a beggar here from the island of Phaeacia. He wishes to talk to you about Ulysses.
Too many people in these past years have come to this house saying always the same thing, hoping for hospitality.
But he says he was a companion of Ulysses in the war.
If you really knew my husband, tell me about him. Why don't you speak? Who are you?
I'm a friend of Ulysses. We were comrades before the walls of Troy. Many a night, as we waited between battles, our thoughts full of sadness, he spoke of you.
And what did he say?
Dark she is, and beautiful in her youth, he said, and full of soft woman's laughter. In such a way she has of brushing her hair absently when she works at her spinning wheel, or watches her sleeping child. Sometimes he spoke of this infant son, Telemachus. Sometimes he spoke of the day of his farewell. How he held you in his arms on the beach by the waiting ships. The foreign stars above our heads.
For too many years, but he, no. He alone among them all.
You are right. It's possible for a man to come back too late.
Wait. Do not go yet. I spoke to you with...
Impossible to bend. Only Ulysses could bend it. You recognize me. Quiet, Argus. Quiet. Yes, old dog. We both have changed, huh? You remember how we hunted the hills from dawn to dusk? You were always the first in the pack. My son. Father.
Father. Father.
Know I'm here.
I cannot wait to tell. I'll tell them all. I'll make them quake with fear and tremble.
Tell no one. Not until we're ready.
Why these strange clothes, Father? Why do you come dressed like a beggar into your own house?
When I set foot here, the gods advised me to do this. And gave me other counsel besides.
But his mother... She's desperate. We'll tell her you've come back.
No. Not even she must know yet. Not until tomorrow. Then will I know if she still loves Ulysses. In the way she did when I left the port of Ithaca.
Lucanto, bring them all away!
In a moment! What do you want? How did you get in here?
As any beggar would. By the servant's gate.
Well, you'd better go before I set the dogs on you. Go on, get out.
Let me ask alms of these noblemen here.
No.
Telemachus, my friend, he won't object.
Telemachus has nothing more to say in this house. Get out.
Let him stay, Lucanthus. Let him stay. You, come here. Come here.
Alms for a child of misfortune? Oh, noble, illustrious friend. Alms for a child of misfortune?
Why don't you go and ask your noble friend Telemachus? He may not be with us much longer.
Beggars were always welcome in the house of Ulysses.
Not only unwashed, but insolent.
Speak as if you are already master here. Surely, Prince, we are both just guests in this house.
Get away, you filthy bundle of rags.
Alms for a child of misfortune.
Here. Here, are you thirsty? Well, drink!
Give him another drink.
thank you, my lords. May the gods reward you.
Here, take this. It's all I can do for you now.
You're kinder than the others, young man. Run away.
Fuja daqui antes que seja tarde demais.
O que está dizendo? É louco? Vamos, fora daqui, Suma!
Até que os jogos terminem, meu caro. Eu é quem decido a quem dar ordens nesta casa.
Ele tem razão, Aquilio. É muito preguiçoso. Alegra-me vê-lo, Telêmaco. O que querem dizer esses machados?
Representam a vontade da rainha. Ela própria explicará.
The language has changed, girls. Yes. Did you notice? I don't know why. I watched it yesterday, I felt. But did you imagine it like that?
Yeah.
Huh.
No.
No. Raise your hand if you want to tell me the difference between the movie and what you read yesterday. Sarah? Okay, Sarah, tell me the difference.
I imagine they were like in a fancy house. Yeah. Like, all of them, they were dressed, like, in a fancy way. And then he came, and then they were talking to him, and then he grabbed the... I don't know, I imagined it's completely different than this.
These are fancy clothes at the time of Odyssey. These were fancy clothes. You see, like, the man is wearing shorts.
I thought Penelope would be prettier than this.
She's pretty.
No, there is pretty.
Here is she. This is a wealthy house. This is Odysseus' house. And those are the suitors.
Who's Miss Antonin's?
I think this one, the main one, this one.
Oh.
Because he was like the villain of the story, of the antagonist of the story. Okay. What else? Odysseus. Huh?
Miss Odyssey, حتى even if he didn't change it, and his clothes بيشبه بيجر كمان عادي.
He looks like a bigger always. Yesterday, someone asked me what happened to the suitors. So, what happened to the suitors? So what happened to the suitors? What happened to the suitors?
They fought the Odyssey.
Yes, he killed them all. He killed the suitors. The Odysseus killed the suitors.
Miss, shouldn't Odyssey have more muscles because he was a warrior?
Yes, he. Look, and there are lots of movies, or lots of versions. This is a new one.
This is a better one.
Give it to me. I will solve this problem once and for all.
They attempt to string your old hunting bow, so they may be worthy to be king.
The trick! No one can string that bow!
I can.
How dare you, beggar! What are you even doing here?
This man is my guest, which is more than I can say of you.
Throw this scum out now!
Are you afraid that a beggar may succeed where you fail?
Of course not.
Then allow me to string the bow. If I should fail, then you can throw me out. Unless you fear me.
I do not fear you. But if you...
Very well.
To know who you are. Who are you?
I am the king of Ithaca.
Impossible. You're a liar. Kill this liar!
So Odysseys have been made for two hundreds of movies, cartoons, animation, lookers of free, and new versions, old versions.
What were the Freudian implications of that one over at Crash Course Psychology? It started. Not in the original Greek, though. Now, everyone knows that you can't properly enjoy a book until you know a lot about its author. So before we discuss the Odyssey, we're going to begin with a biographical sketch of Homer, the legendary blind poet of ancient Greece. What's that? Apparently, we know nothing about him. Well, in fact, we know that whoever wrote them didn't actually write them because they were composed orally. And was Homer even blind? Well, there are some verses about blindness in the Homeric hymns, and there's a blind bard who appears...
Talking about Homer's here.
Homer?
Here's in the Odyssey. But if authors only wrote about characters who were like them.
Who was blind?
Homer.
Who was blind? Homer, the poet who wrote the Odyssey, girls.
So then James Joyce's characters would have all had one eye, and I would be an astonished. About the Trojan War, but Homer's were by far the most famous, and they are now the most famous because they...
This is a written version of the Odyssey, guys. Look at this.
We're also the only ones to survive the burning of the library at Alexandria. So the Iliad and the Odyssey are epic poems, and we define an epic as a long narrative poem on a serious subject written in a grand or elevated style centered on a larger-than-life hero. By the way, that was an example of dactylic hexameter, just like you see in epic poems. So the events of the Odyssey take place after those of the Iliad, so let's have a brief recap thought bubble. So Helen, the wife of Menelaus, runs off with Paris, a Trojan prince, or maybe she's abducted, it's not clear. Anyway, Menelaus's brother Agamemnon gathers allies and goes to Troy to get her back, but the war drags on for 10 years, at which point relents and they have dinner together, and then the book ends with the war still going.
Here he's talking about the Iliad.
On and nothing really resolved. And that, drinking all of his wine, eating by the nymph Calypso, who's so hot for Odysseus, even though he spends his days laying on the beach and crying, that a dozen suitors who have been drinking series of adventures and a whole lot of backstory, he finally returns home to Ithaca in disguise and kills several dozen.
This is it. He returned back home to Ithaca and disguised as a beggar and killed
suitors who have been drinking all of his wine, eating his beeves, annoying his wife, and plotting to kill his son. And it seems like a cycle of violence is just going to continue on probably forever until the goddess Athena, who loves Odysseus, intervenes and restores peace. The end. Thanks, Thought Bubbles.
That's it, girls. Okay.
Yes.
There are a lot of movies you can watch. Okay. So we go back to our topic. Yesterday we saw page 65, girls, right? We analyzed the interaction between characters and events. The event, yes. and quotation from the text.
Yes.
So today we'll take the second read. Listen, girls, when we said, when I told you that Athens had cursed Odysseus, what did he say to him? What are the insults that Odysseus gave?
Insects.
Huh? Yes, insects. What brought this witch blow, brought this pest here, right?
Mm-hmm.
What else? What did else he say?
Die before your marriage?
Yeah, no, this is Odysseus said to him. This is Odysseus said to Antinous. I want and what Antinous said to Odysseus.
The Egyptian whips are sweet.
Yes?
When Antinous said that the Egyptian whips are sweet.
Yes, Egyptian whips are sweet, yes. Because he referring to that Odysseus was a slave and he has been whipped. What else? Yes, when he threw this tool. Okay, girls, what do you think of Antinous' behavior?
Rude. Disrespectful.
Is that because you know that the beggar is Odysseus or what?
No, because he treated a beggar this way.
Because
the way he treated the beggar.
Yes, yes. Because he treats the beggar that way. So your reaction towards Antinous will not be different if you know that the beggar is Odysseus or another normal beggar, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Oh.
So let's see our core point and then discuss. Here is secondary core. Okay, good. So in here, girls, we will analyze dramatic irony. We will analyze dramatic irony. What's dramatic irony? While we were reading, we discovered that we have more than dramatic irony sitting here in the story. What is dramatic irony, we said?
So when the reader knows something that the character...
That we don't know.
Yes. Listen, girls, dramatic irony knows when I know something as a reader, another character in the story doesn't know anything about it. Okay. Girls, I would like to hide my camera for a while because there is, I want to cut a part of the video and publish it. So I don't want my face to be shown. Okay. Here is it. So, girls, we will discuss dramatic irony. And dramatic irony, as we said, it happens when the reader, as a reader, knows something another character in the story doesn't know. Have you heard about Shakespeare, girls?
Yeah.
Shakespeare, the greatest English author. What is his famous novel?
The Tragedy of Hamlet.
Uh-huh, yes, and this picture in the PowerPoint.
Romeo and Juliet.
Yes, Romeo and Juliet. Yes, Romeo and Juliet, the ending depends on dramatic irony. How? Both of them agreed that they will pretend to be dead, so no one can separate them. Juliet drank the poison, a fake one, that will make her sleep for like 2 hours. Romeo thought that Juliet has died. So he took a poison. This is dramatic irony. Why? Because we as readers know that she didn't take a poison, but he didn't know. He thought that she has died. So what did he do? He took a poison to die, to kill himself. Because he knows that she is dead. Then he died. When he died, she woke up from her death because she was not dead. She just took this poison to make her sleep for 2 hours. So this is dramatic irony, girls. You understand it?
Yes. Yes.
It's when we know something, as we said before, when we know that the killer is up in the second roof and the woman is going up to the second roof and we want her to stop Okay, but she is going because she doesn't know. This is dramatic irony. When the reader knows something, another character in the story doesn't know, or the main character in the story doesn't know. Okay? In the Odyssey girls, what is the dramatic irony?
Can I say?
Yes, please. What's your name, dear?
Noor Youssef.
Yes, yeah, Noor.
Miss, when Penelope asked to see the beggar, we knew that the beggar was Odyssey, but she didn't know that he was Odysseus.
Excellent. Number one, when Penelope wanted to see the beggar, she didn't know that he is her husband, but we know. What is the second dramatic irony? Girls, I cannot see your names, so if you notice, yes, please, Lujaine.
Antinous refused to give Odysseus some food, and while it was Odysseus' home to begin with.
Yes, Odysseus begged for food at his own house. Antinous refused to give him food, and he doesn't know that this is Odysseus, the owner of the house. What is another irony, girls?
Can I say, miss?
Yes, please.
When the people believe that Odysseus was a god, but we actually know he's not a god.
Yes, when they thought that he is a god, but we know that he is not a god. When someone doubted that he may be a god and disguised in the cloud of a beggar. What else? So, we will analyze dramatic irony here. So open with me page 66. Before we move on, let's discuss some questions. Okay. Why it is ironic? Is it ironic that Antinous accused the beggar of impudence in line 65? Go to line 65, girls. Why is it ironic that Antinous accuses the beggar of being impudence?
Do we answer?
Yes, answer usually.
Maybe because Antinous himself was sitting at someone's home and taking food while he refuses to give others to give the beggar food from the house that's not his house.
Yes, excellent. Because Antinous himself acts like a beggar. Yes, he sits in another man's house and takes advantage of the wealth of another man's house. Antinous thinks that the beggar is rude and respectful for criticizing his actions. It is ironic because he is the one who is disrespecting Odysseus at Odysseus' house. Question number two. What makes Odysseus' curse in line 84 and 85 especially ironic? Go to line 84 and 85. Layan, are you here, Layan?
Which one?
Yes, 84 and
85. Which layam? Okay. Mr. Not true, but I think it's because when he said, may he meet his death before his wedding day, because he was supposed to marry Paris, Penelope, and Penelope is his wife, is Odysseus' wife.
Yes. Okay. The observation that Antinous would be marrying Odysseus' wife. Okay, that Odysseus, if he didn't come, who would have married his wife?
Antinous.
Antinous. Okay. Three. Are the housekeeper's words in lines 114, 116 an example of dramatic irony? 114 and 116. Go to the lines, girls, and tell me. Girls?
Yes.
girls in 114, 116, when she said, when Penelope said, if all we pray for came to pass, not one would live till dawn, she wishes everyone down will be killed by Apollo. Okay, but she doesn't know that who is there. She doesn't know who's there.
Odyssey.
Yes, her husband, Odysseus. Are you with me, girls?
Yes,
yes.
Why are you asleep? Girls, I have 31 girls. I hear only the voices of three girls. Is it hard? We're just discussing some questions. What's wrong? Hello?
Yes.
Please be with me. Here is it. I will not record. Here is it. I will not cut anything. Yeah. Here is it, girls.
Yes, math.
What did you have previous period?
Math,
and that's why you're asleep, or what? Or you didn't sleep well? Jumana, are you here, Jumana?
Yes, miss.
Yes, read, please.
One of the elements that make this expert from the Odyssey so interesting that is that the use of dramatic irony. Irony is a literary device in which the reader and some of the characters know knowledge that the rest of the characters don't have. Dramatic irony is often used in plays and movies. A classic example occurs in Romeo and Juliet, when Romeo believes Juliet is dead, goes to her tomb, commits suicide. The audience knows that Juliet is actually in a deep sleep and has plans to run away with Romeo. As the audience watches Romeo pine for his lost Juliet, emotions are intensified by the knowledge that we have. That we have,
and Romeo doesn't. We know, so dramatic irony in the scene of Romeo and Juliet, we know that she's not dead, but he is committing suicide. So we are intense. Will he die or will he stay alive? Okay, then here, question number in page 66. He will give me example from the text. What is the character saying and why is this an example of dramatic irony? We will read number one together. Girls, Kadra,
yes,
Kadra, example from the text.
Given my friend, I would not say myself, you are the worst man of the young
Achaean.
The noblest brother, kingly by your look, therefore you will give me more bread than others do. What is the character saying? Odysseus is asking a stranger to give him food. He flatters him, pretending to be a humble beggar. Why is this an example of dramatic irony? We know that Odysseus is being begging for his own bread and flattering a man who's trying to marry his own wife.
Yes. So, an example from the text when he said, give my mic, my friend. When Odysseus, what is the character saying? Odysseus is asking for food, pretending to be a beggar. Why this is an example of dramatic irony? We know Odysseus begging for his own bread and flattering a man, and he wants to marry his wife. This is it. Let's see number two. Example from the text. Okay, Dora, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Read, Dora.
Example from the text. A poor show that hitting this famished tramp, bad business if he happened to be a god. You know they go in foreign clothes.
Guys. The gods do.
The gods do, looking like strangers, turning up in towns and settlements to keep an eye on manners, good or bad, line 94 to 99.
So what is the character saying here?
the crowd warns Antinous that the gods often appear as strangers to check on humans.
So why this is an example of dramatic irony? One of the crowd says, watch out, maybe the beggar is a god. What is dramatic irony here?
Do we answer this?
Yes. Who can answer? Who knows the answer?
Can I?
We did Sarah. Anyone else? What, Sarah knows the answer?
Miss Leanne is the one talking.
Leanne, not Sarah? I'm sorry. I can't see the names.
Do I answer?
Okay, Leanne, answer.
They think Odysseus might be a god, but we know he's... No, the beggar might be a god, but we know he's Odysseus.
Yes, yes. The reader knows that Odysseus is the one in disguise, so he can check on the state of his household and the faithfulness of his wife. So people in the story thought he might be God, but we know that he is Odysseus. Okay, now we have to bring examples from the text and say what is the character saying and say was it, this is an example of dramatic irony.
Can I say, Miss?
Sarah, okay, Sarah.
When Penelope was asking what was his name? Eumaeus?
Yes, Eumaeus. Eumaeus
used to bring up the beggar to tell her if he knows like anything about Odysseus. But yes, the dramatic irony, it's that we know that he's Odysseus, not the beggar.
Yes, we know the beggar himself is Odysseus. What is another dramatic irony, girls? جاي نجوى نور غادة نوت داليا دارين shall I call each one by her name? ناتالي ملك وسيم فاطمة رغد.
I already mentioned all the dramatic irony.
Yes, ما I want one of them again. Another, let's see. Look. So I can greet and question. This is what Sarah answered now. And the great word, they may have heard rumors about Odysseus, may have known him. What is the character saying? Penelope wants to talk to the beggar because he may have news of Odysseus. The reader knows that the beggar is Odysseus, but Penelope doesn't. So this is number three. Number four, who knows?
Can I? Yes? It's like eat and be quiet, where are you, or shamble elsewhere until you want these lads to stop your mouth. Because yes, when he cursed the Antinous.
Yes. When Antinous cursed Odysseus. Yes.
When Odysseus cursed Antinous.
Yes. When Odysseus cursed Antinous, he said to him what?
He said that I hope you die before your wedding day.
Yes, because we know that Odysseus is planning to kill all the suitors of the house. But they don't know that he himself is Odysseus. Okay, another one. Just so I found myself enchanted by this man. This is whom Eumaeus was talking about, Odysseus. Right?
Yes.
What is character saying? Eumaeus is praising the beggar. Says the beggar knows Odysseus. He wants to encourage Penelope to talk to him. Why is this ironic?
Because the beggar himself is Odysseus?
Yes. We know that the beggar doesn't just have close ties with Odysseus. He is Odysseus. Okay, another one.
Miss?
Yes.
Did Eumaeus know that the beggar? No.
So the last one goes, if he can believe he has news of Odysseus near at hand, alive in the rich country of Thesropatia, bringing a massive treasure home, Eumaeus implies that the beggar has news about Odysseus. Again, we know that Eumaeus is talking about Odysseus himself, so of course he has news about him. Okay, girls? This is a homework in page 68. He wants you to write a paragraph explanation the explaining the irony of the situation. So you write like this. You pick any situation, an example of dramatic irony. This is ironic because of that. The irony adds tension because of that. The irony adds suspense because of that. This is what you're going to write. You will just tell me these lines. I, of course, after I finish, I will upload for you the PowerPoint presentation.
Miss, do we write them like this, points or as a paragraph?
As a paragraph. I'll connect them together as a paragraph.
Okay.
I will upload it after I finish. Let's go now and join the second class, girls.
Bye.